WVTC Radio Detroit. You can find us on Facebook, YouTube, our website, www.wvtcradio.com, or download our WVTC app from the Play Store for Android users and the App Store for iPhone users.
WVTCRadio.com and the Sandy Rose Show with your host, Sandy Rose, where you'll hear the finest in gospel music and information you can use. The Sandy Rose Show can be heard every Tuesday from 5 to 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So get your pencil, paper, and your shouting shoes as you listen to today's broadcast. Why not text a friend and tell them to listen too?
O Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds that thy hands have made, you stood somewhere behind the great, grand, and glorious hills of eternity. Rearrange your agenda for the creation of this vast universe. You reached down with your omnipotent hand into the great abyss of nothingness and threw nothing out into nowhere, and nothing became something. What a world we live in. Look at this world. It's gigantic and it's grand. Mountain heights with scintillating views, valleys scooped out by eternal hands, rolling prairies, running brooks, rippling streams blessed with gold, silver, diamonds, and all kinds of precious minerals. My soul sings when I look and see how God splashed a multitude of stars kissing the heavens like diamonds sprinkled against black velvet and hanging like trapezes from the roof of God's gymnasium. You placed the moon and announced for the world to hear, this is the queen of the night, and she has never stopped shining. The oceans, whose depths have to be measured in miles. The sun has never run out of gas. The stars keep coming out to play. The seasons still march in splendid succession. My God is real. He is from everlasting to everlasting. He even looked around one day to see what he had created and said, "That's good." And one day, when he brings everything to consummation and a glorious fruition, when he comes with a shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart? When he calls me, I will answer and I will bow in humble adoration, and my soul will say, how great thou art. For I know I have a house of many mansions, eternal in the heavens, up where Jesus lives, up beyond the atmosphere, the stratosphere, the exosphere, the troposphere, up where I'll never grow old, up to the streaks of gold, up beyond the vicissitudes of life. And I will honor him as King of Kings and Lord of Lords, and simply say to him that is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever, and forever and forever. My God, how great thou art.
God in heaven, this evening, we do praise you and thank you for this another opportunity, another day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. God, we're grateful because you woke us up this morning, started us on our way, and we had a reasonable portion of health and strength for this day. God, you were with us with every decision that we've made today, every choice that we made today. All that we were doing, you were right there. And we know that because you are omnipresent God. So you're everywhere at the same time. You don't have to get there. You're already there. And for this, we are grateful. And this comforts us to know that our God is very present. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done for us and all that you're going to do. Thank you for being a God that hears and answers prayer and that you care all about us. Thank you, God. Thank you for giving us the opportunity, Lord God, just to praise you one more time, to talk about you to your people one more time here at WVTC, Detroit Internet Radio. We thank you for this opportunity. Now, God, everybody that's listening, everybody that's watching, we ask a special blessing on their behalf. Draw them closer to you. Give them a thirsting for your righteousness, because if you do that, they shall be filled. Let them delight themselves in you, because if they do that, you'll give them the desires of their heart. We're standing on your word today, for we know your word is true. So bless God as only you can. And we're claiming everything well in Jesus' name and in order. Now, God, you get the glory, you get the honor, and you get all the praise. And it is in your precious but powerful name, Jesus, that we pray. Amen, and thank God. Wherever you are, give God some praise. Give him some thanks, and I tell you every day, expect your miracle. Don't get tired of waiting on God, because he ain't get tired of waiting on you. Don't get tired of waiting on God. He's answered, your prayer has been answered. You just got to wait for the answer to get to you. It's coming from eternity into time. It has a date on it. Trust God. He heard you. Expect it in Jesus' name. Tell him thank you.
I'm a worshiper. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Do I have any more worshipers here? I mean a worshiper.
When I think of our Father, the Creator.
worship you. Not for fame nor vain glory, not for riches untold, but because he's God Almighty, I begin to worship him.
Whether you
want. He may not give you the answer you want.
He may not give you what you want.
But he will answer.
He's going to answer.
He's going to answer.
And he will do what's best.
And he ain't
hard
of hearing.
No. No. And he will do what's best for
that's
you.
That's it. He'll do what's best
that's
for
the,
you.
That's the kicker right there. He'll do what's best for you. It's another good day.
Great day.
Another good day.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And that Bishop Mitchell was.
Ooh-wee.
Sometimes that hard word is what you need, you know, to take that medicine, and you'll feel a little better after it gets down and started working.
He always give me a nugget. Every week he give me a nugget. I said, that's the one I needed this week.
He's wonderful. He's wonderful. We've had a good broadcasting day yesterday, and we're looking for another great broadcasting day today. We have a special guest in our midst, Brother Dwayne Parham.
Amen.
Detroit's own. And he has been playing around the city of Detroit and other places, but we've known about his ministry for years, and wherever he's playing, he takes the Lord with him.
Amen.
He's done some marvelous things for this city, but we are glad to be here.
Yeah.
How was your week so far?
Good week. I've been resting because I had to rest. You know, we had Mr.'s birthday party over the weekend. We invited people over, so I had to do some cleaning.
Some clinking.
That you've been telling us about. We did some cleaning.
Some cleaning.
And I've been needing to do some cleaning for a while. So,
he enjoy?
That's
the whole
point. It just lifted up his spirits, because, you know, he's still mending.
Yeah.
And all. And so I just told people, come over to the house and say happy birthday to him.
Yeah.
You know, so of course I cooked. And
of course.
And they.
What's a party without the food?
Right. So he had a great time, and I'm glad.
And we
both recovering.
I know that's right, because I thought I was recovered. And Saints, when you get a little bit older, it takes you a little bit more time to come on through, you know. And we had the big weekend this weekend.
Yeah.
I just knew. But when I went to work yesterday, I was a little off.
I was a little off.
And I asked some of the others that were on the committee, and they said we was a little off too. But we felt that we all texted each other this morning. It was like, we feel a little better today. So, it takes you a little bit longer to recover when you get past 21. So those of you who are,
past 21.
Yeah, below that age, just know it's coming.
Right.
So I used to be able to catch that red eye.
Oh, girl.
And go right on into work and do what I needed to do.
Ooh.
Not no more.
I can't do that. One thing, none of it.
No, I wouldn't think
couple hours of sleep.
I get it on a regular basis.
Keep it popping. Do it. Boom, 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 boom. And wasn't even breathing hard.
Wasn't breathing hard, honey. But I caught that red. I had a regular seat on that girl.
See.
But not no more.
But God is good. God is good.
He is
still in the blessing business.
He is.
I'm so glad he loves me. I'm so glad. And I'm so glad I know him.
I know that's right. I know that's right. So, and we also have, I know that we were talking about something yesterday, and I see that our special guest, we have another special guest that's on the page.
All right. Have chimed in online.
She has chimed in online.
All right.
I really, really hope that you do not have to go, because I'd like to bring you on at the 5:40 hour.
Okay.
So I hope you don't have to go anywhere. And let's get this together, because I want you to call in. So I'm going to get that number and get all that together. But we were talking yesterday about good times. And the song.
And the lyrics.
And we have the actual singer of the song that's going to come online today. Yes. So this is a special treat. Mm-hmm. So we're going to work some things out, and we'll be right back. Engineer, is you ready for
it? Is we ready?
All right. So let's we're going to play a song from our special guest today. And this one is I Need a Miracle.
Okay.
And this is
Do Mr. You Need a Miracle Out There?
Honey. Okay.
Because I still need some miracles.
Plural.
Things that I know God.
That's right.
God, you know, the impossible. You do the possible. I do the possible. He does the impossible.
All right. So I Need a Miracle. We'll be right back. This is Dwayne Parham. And we'll be right back with him right after this song. This is WVTC, the gospel radio station right here in Detroit. Okay. Then how about I Surrender by Mr. Dwayne Parham? All right, that was I Surrender All. Mm. And that was you, Mr. Dwayne Parham. Yay.
Thank you.
And we're glad to have you.
Well, I'm glad to be here. Yes. I'm so honored to be here.
Yay. And now you recorded that with Greater New Mount Moriah.
Yes.
Okay.
I recall when our minister of music, Herman Harris.
We know him. Yes, we know him.
He asked me to play on the concert. And I said, well, sure. What would you like me to play? Mm-hmm. And he said, well, I would like for you to play that particular song. And I have played it before, but I've also played it with my soprano saxophone. But he wanted me to play tenor.
Okay.
And I said, well, Herman, I don't play much tenor. But he said, I like you playing that. So that's what I did.
Okay.
Played the tenor saxophone.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm. It sounds wonderful. Mm-hmm. It sounds wonderful.
Thank you.
And we're so glad that you were here. We saw you at the fashion show.
Right.
Over at Little Rock.
Little Rock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, with Reverend Holly. And we're so glad that you were able to come and grace the studios here.
Yes, well, that's what it is. If you don't go out, nobody know about you. So
they called me to play for the fashion show.
So I had a good time. And then I met you there. Or we met you again because you shared with me that you was a friend of my sister's.
That's right. That's right. And for those of you who are watching from our Michigan Bell days, SBC, and all that, this is Rhonda Parham's brother. Amen. Some people call her Bonnie.
Yes. Yeah. Yes,
and
yes.
We just called her Parham.
Yeah. Yeah. My uncle gave her that name.
Oh, okay. All right. All right. And we bless her memory right now. But we're so glad to have you. Now, you're a member of Greater New Mount Moriah?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we shout out to Pastor Flowers.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
We shout out to Pastor Flowers for being such a great leader in
this city.
Amen. Yes. Amen. Mm-hmm. So now, I was watching a couple clips. Now, you've been playing. How long have you been playing?
I've been playing since I was 14. And
really? Oh,
yes.
Mm-hmm. You've been playing a while.
Yeah, I've been playing
a while. Yeah, okay. So did you start in school? Or?
Well, yeah, I started playing in
band.
School. Yeah, in band. I'm trying to, it seems like all this should be fresh in my mind. I just finished my autobiography.
Yes. Wow, yeah. That's great.
And you know, what is this right here? This just so happened to be a copy of my
Okay. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay.
And
how can they get this?
Well, they can go to
and it's a hardback.
My web. I have hardbacks and softbacks, and also audio. So it's
really?
12 chapters in the book.
Okay.
And each one of the chapters, you have a CD with the orchestra behind. Playing behind every narrator, and one of the persons who narrating a great singer by the name of Lauren Harper, and he's narrating my voice being me. Such a great job, and I had the Toronto, Canada Digital Orchestra play behind every word. Sounds like a soap opera.
Okay.
So when you're listening to it, it just draws you in. And will not let you go.
And that's with the DVD.
That's with the DVD.
Okay.
Okay. And we can get that on Amazon.
You can get it from Amazon. You can also go to my nonprofit Educational Arts, the radio station.
Okay.
And it's on there. And the book is slightly higher on the website because we take some of the funds goes to the kids. We purchase musical instruments and we give them free instruments.
Okay. Yes.
And that's great. A lot of schools now, you know, they're struggling with the instrumental music department.
Maintaining a music department.
Yes, right. Period. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, with the instruments, they can't get the instruments.
True, true.
You know, so that's and a great
getting,
work.
And also getting the instruments repaired.
One of the
because you need pads.
One of the musical legends, Mr. Kasuku Mafia, who played with Motown.
Okay.
His family gave our company all his instruments, most of them, or a lot of them. And some of the kids have been fortunate enough to get his instruments, but some of them needed repairs. Right now, I have a baritone saxophone that his family blessed us with that needs to be repaired. And there's an alto clarinet and a few other instruments, but some of the other instruments were good, and some of the kids got them. Plus, we bought a lot of new instruments, too.
Okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. And what's the name of your...
Educational Arts Society.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And is there a website? Yes. I mean, you know, the people want to help you because they want to buy, they want to they want to get that.
The it's EA, oh, got so many EA companies. It's EAS. Oh, boy, I need to write this down.
We'll get it while we're on break.
Good,
and
good.
After we get to the next song.
Right.
Okay.
But it's saying a candid, honest look into the life of a Motown jazz gospel legend.
Mm-hmm.
Now, tell us about Motown, your connection.
Well, I've never been signed with Motown. My Motown is Detroit.
It's Detroit. Okay. Because we are Motown.
We are Motown.
Right. That's right.
And although I had the honor and privilege of producing the Tops, the Contours, the original Vandellas, a lot of great musicians on my latest CD entitled Motor City Sax Appeal, my tribute to the Motown legends.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then also I finished a documentary entitled... the unsung musicians of the Motown Empire.
Oh,
all about the
horn
players that played with Motown.
Okay.
And just a great piece. A lot of the musicians like Teddy Harris and, Marcus Belgrave and Ernie Rogers have made their transitions, but they left gold on my documentary.
They did.
And I'm so honored that family members helped out and had parties, you know, afterwards at their home to even, you know, to donate.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just been a labor of love. And all the musicians, I can think of the when Detroit was going through a problem around 2013, I called together a lot of Detroit artists to sing on a song I wrote.
Uh-huh.
So I didn't. I didn't have inkling that it would be so big. What I did, I called everybody who wanted to be in this in this song to meet down at this club called Burt's.
Yeah.
And 3 weeks later, when I got down there, I had saw people everywhere. So I went to the owner. I said, "Well, Burt, you said that I could have the place for this day, and you have people everywhere."
Uh-huh.
And he said, "Yeah. Well, they're here for you." So. It was just, we had so many people, over 200 musicians and singers that were there.
Wow.
So this is just for one song.
Okay.
And so the Lord put on my spirit what to do.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So I came out of all of that with 15 different genres of that one song.
Okay.
Gospel, jazz, reggae, salsa. Yeah. And it's just a wonderful project.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I saw something on YouTube, and you were producing a song about Detroit.
Yeah, that's the name. Detroit City is Coming Back.
Detroit City is Coming Back.
Yes.
Yeah, that was an interesting a video.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
And it was you guys in the studio.
Right. Yeah. Well, we did a lot of, I sort of documented every time we were in the studio with my camera.
That's good.
And we just had a good time. Although it was serious business, but we just had
Yeah,
good
it looks
time.
Like you guys are having a great time. A great time. Mm-hmm. Well, we're going to go to one of the songs, and I want you to tell me about that before we do.
Okay.
And we'll give some shout-outs.
Okay.
But you did a song with one of our friends and fellow choir members.
Amen.
Pastor Lydia Wright.
Right.
Yeah.
Former Whitfield Company member.
Well, Lydia is, she not only sung that song with me, but she opened my documentary with the prologue. She's the voice of my mother. And she just did a great job.
Wow.
Between her and Lauren, just awesome. Awesome, awesome.
Mm-hmm. Wow. And so you were born here in Detroit?
Yes, I was, yes.
Okay, so you're a native Detroiter. What school?
I know that's right. Which high school?
Right. Yeah, go we to? Went to what school?
I went to Northwestern.
Okay. The big N-O.
And when my family moved, I graduated from Cooley High School.
So okay.
I have love at both places.
Both ends of the neighborhood.
But it's West Side.
Because you know, I remember when my family moved, I was leaving all my friends behind.
That's right.
So I was heartbroken. Yeah. But when I got to Cooley, my horn made friends to everybody before I did.
Okay.
So it was a little easy, you know.
Okay.
And
okay.
I wrote this play entitled Alone in This World. And the song you're going to play, that's the soundtrack. Now, I have re-recorded it because I'm doing something very special with the song and my play. So you'll hear about that soon as well.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And we'll give some shout-outs when we come back. But I want you to hear this song. And it's Pastor Lydia Wright Price and Dwayne Parham.
Alone in This World.
Alone in This World. We'll be right back. This is WVTC, the gospel radio station. Get this. That's one of the first.
Let's go.
Right, all right. That was
Lydia Wright.
Yeah.
That was sure Lydia Wright. On my, that was my first CD, I believe, my first gospel CD. It's about 13 songs on that, but Lydia did such a great job. And I used that a lot because it was my opening for the play. Okay. And it was like the soundtrack for the play.
Mm-hmm. So yeah. Now, is this the have you done the play?
Oh yeah, I've done traveled the play in a lot of different secondary markets, and that was a few years back. But my surprise will come when folks hear about the play coming back soon.
Okay. Well, you have to let us know when you are auditioning and all of that.
Most certainly.
Because we have a mess of, a plethora of artists that watch the show.
Wonderful.
They would be interested in
Wonderful.
That.
Wonderful.
They would be interested in that. So now, how long have you been recording?
Wow. I've been recording some time, and I never thought about the time. I've just been recording. And just having fun doing it, and just getting better as I go along every day. Mm-hmm. So
do you still practice every day?
All the time, yes. See, more so than ever.
Did you hear that? Young people, you practice often?
More so than ever. I mean, I practice quite a bit.
Yes. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And I noticed they had some Billboard credits. So you've had songs, well, WJZZ.
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm.
And, you know, you've had some jazz credits there.
Yes. I've done quite a few things. And but right now, what's so important, my nonprofit, getting instruments to the kids, and that's something. Amen. My plan is to build a school of performing arts in Detroit.
Okay.
And so all this is the prelude to that. And if you would like to purchase the book or a copy, you can go to the radio site, Educational Arts, Music, and Talk Radio. The website is eamtradio.com. And you can also go to the nonprofit. That's easymusic.org.
Okay. Don't worry about it. We'll make sure. We will make sure that we put it on our page.
Wonderful.
And you'll be able to purchase this.
And I'll
you'll be able to get the book.
right.
We'll be able to get the book. You'll be able to get this Lessons in the Key of Life. This is great. And this is a DVD, right?
Yeah, that's a DVD, yes.
Right, mm-hmm. So you can not only hear it, but mm-hmm. you can watch it.
Oh, yeah. Well, no, you know what? That
this
is a
CD.
CD.
Okay.
That's a CD. And I have 12 chapters, and that's chapter 6. That's talks about a lot of good stuff. You got to get it. I'm just amazed.
And this is something you can put in your car. Or
That's right. Yeah. I'm so amazed.
And it's easy
at this
listening,
list.
I see. Yeah. Good, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
I'm just so amazed at this list.
Right. So we can start giving out some shout outs because have a lot of your friends. Let's see, Carol Bennett, Rex Edwards, Doug Firewater.
Yeah.
Lester German.
Yeah. My.
Christine Barge.
Wow.
And Moanne.
Moanne and Misty Love.
Yep. Deborah Williams.
Charlotte Settles. Oh, my.
Gwendolyn Parrott.
Right, Gwen. Northwestern. Yes. We got Kevin.
Made his mind up. I like that.
Well, yeah, that's probably Kevin.
Pat Taylor,
yes. My. Gene Simmons.
Yep.
Cooley High.
Okay. Sue Z.D. Rice.
Yes.
Marlene Johnson. Now, was she a neighbor? Was that the one
that
was a neighbor?
I think that might be Madeline, maybe. I think that's her.
Okay.
Yes, I think so. Mm-hmm.
All right. Shirley Thompson.
Shirley Thompson and Joe Crawford.
Yep.
I believe that's Bebop's brother. And Ronald Stewart. Oh, my. We had some time together. Wow.
Okay.
Wisconsin.
Oh, okay. Wisconsin Street, huh?
No, Madison, Wisconsin.
Oh, Madison. Okay. Yeah. All right. Really?
We played for the Modern Jazz Combo as kids under the direction of James Tatum. And yeah. Tatum put together, he chose some of his students, such as James Lou Lewis, who plays trombone, Charles Hopkins on trumpet, Ronald Stewart on percussions. I can't think of Ricky's name. He played drums. And I know I'm missing someone. But it's all in the book.
Say get the book.
Yes, and all those guys are in the book, and so many people that are passed across, mm-hmm. I talk about them in the book.
Mm-hmm. All right, yes. And we've got Ramon Jones, Desiree Seaton Hester, Ronald Stewart.
Yep, that's right.
We've got Darlene Harris, Richard Darrell Nichols.
Oh, I saw Sami Mohammed. I saw Sami Mohammed.
Yeah, you did.
Good friend. We grew up together, and he is a minister.
Okay.
Minister and Mohammed. In fact, he invited me to come see Farrakhan Sunday, and I was there. Thank you. Thank you, Sami.
All right. Yes. Yeah, thank you, Minister. Savior's Day.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Ron Paulus, mm-hmm. V. Tracy McQueen, Patricia Ford, mm-hmm. Bishop Raymond Johnson.
Oh, that's the names.
Marlene Richardson, Colette Webb, Ella Major, Tashana Marie, mm-hmm. Wilson, our niece. Yes. Jernice Brown. And we have a special guest, which is Blinky Williams, and she's going to talk. Do you know Blinky?
No, I don't.
Okay, Blinky is she's from Motown.
Okay.
And she sang the Good Time song.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Just looking out of the window. Mm-hmm. And so we had an issue yesterday with the words. Okay. So she is going to come on and tell us exactly what the words to the song are.
Wonderful.
Yeah, Teresa Acton, Bonnie Talbert, Lena Brown, Regina Gambrell, and Darlene Harris, Edna Bell. We're happy to have her on our own, Edna Bell. Evie is watching. So we have a lot. Gail Peterson is watching. Mm-hmm. Michael Peters is watching. Mm-hmm. So we have a lot of people out here. Linda Gardner, Ronald Welch.
Yes. Yes. Yes, Ron Welch. We used to meet up every Sunday.
Okay.
At Transforming Love Community Church.
Okay.
And before then, we were at Brown's Chapel together. He's a drummer, wonderful, awesome singer.
Okay.
Yeah, Ron Welch. And Al Lindsay.
All the music.
We just did a concert together at Aretha Franklin's.
Tribute.
Well, at the music.
Cafe.
Cafe.
Oh,
at the cafe.
And, we have a few other shout outs with Vicky. My friend, Vicky King Smith. Hey, Vic, it's been a while since I've seen her. My cousin down in I think she's in Atlanta, Cheryl Wedwine, and baby sister, Vicky Townsend is watching. And let's see, Belafonte Lane is watching. Ron, my nephew Ron Beeks is watching. And my cousin Gerald is watching. So I got a lot of family that's watching. Brian Thompson is watching. And Trina is watching. And my niece, Brandy Roberts, she's in Canada. And First Lady Robin Davis in Baltimore, Maryland. Columbia, Maryland, actually, is watching. So glad to have all of you.
Very fine trombonist. Right.
Bugs
Bettles.
That's right. Yes. That's right. Bugs. That's right. That's right. Yes. You brought all the musicians to the yard.
The Gilmore Brothers, I didn't get a chance to talk to anybody.
So you went online. But you see how social media works?
Social media. Yeah.
Well, I tell you what. I asked people who purchased my book mm-hmm. to send me a picture. And they started sending me pictures. So I'm going to post the pictures on my page.
Yeah.
So everybody's grinning with their...
with their seed. Yeah.
Oh, it looks great. I am so honored. I'm so honored. It's just fabulous.
Yeah, yeah. It's just, so now, yes. Who were your mentors?
Oh, I had so many. So many. I got to start off with my dad.
Okay. And he played.
Mom. No, he just.
He just wasn't encouraging. Okay.
You have to get the book to tell you everything.
Okay.
We will get the book.
Sometimes I see people and they say, "Don't you remember when we?" And I'm like, you know what? No offense, but sometimes I don't remember where I put my keys in the morning and I get ready to leave. I'm running back and forth trying to find my keys, but. Yes, you have to read the book. I just thank God that he kept my memory together to come up with all these things. And I mm-hmm. remember things that you know, way back.
Yeah.
And so many different friends that I come and cross, you know, mm-hmm. our paths crossed mm-hmm. that I can mm-hmm. talk about.
Now, have you traveled abroad with your music?
No, I haven't. But I tell you one thing. I remember when... this sister prophesied to me. She said, "You're going to go worldwide. You're going to be all over." Mm-hmm. And I'm like, "Okay, I accept. And WGPR closed. This is about seven, eight years ago. Mm-hmm. And the musical director, Karen, her name is Karen, mm-hmm. she had, when it closed, she lost her job there.
Yeah.
So her husband started a station called Cats Radio. Okay. And she called me three times and she said, "Dwayne, if you come on my show, I mean, you're going to be heard all over."
Yeah.
And we worldwide, Dwayne. And I'm like, "Okay, that's the first time." So she called me back and she said, "Well, Dwayne, this is what it costs." And I said, "No way I'm going to be able to be on your show." So I let it go. So the third time, I remembered what was prophesied to me.
Okay.
So I said, "Well, you know, I think I'm going to try this out."
Okay.
And I had a session that day. I had the Vandellas were with me, uh-huh. Pat Lewis, and the musical director for the Temptations was with me, McKinley Jackson.
Okay.
So I said, "Look, we're going to go to the station, and I'm going to do my first day at the station. I'm going to just try it out, see how I like it."
Okay.
I sat down on the phone at the microphone, and the guy pointed at me, and I said, "Ladies and gentlemen, this is your host, Dwayne Parham. I'm on the microphone, not on the saxophone, but coming to you live, all the way live from Cats Radio." Mm-hmm. And then when he waved to me, "Take a break," I jumped back and I stood up and did the moonwalk. I said, I like this.
Well, you know, and this is worldwide, too.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, we have
to. That's why I'm honored to be here.
Yeah.
I'm worldwide.
Yeah, you're worldwide. That prophecy was true. Right?
Yeah, you say if I've gone abroad, yes.
Yeah, because most of my names don't live in Michigan.
Yeah.
That I called out. Yeah. Most of them don't live in Michigan.
I understand. I know exactly what you're talking
about. Yeah. So this is great. And mm-hmm. and to watch prophecy mm-hmm. because it's something you were raised in the church.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And you were raised at which church?
Well, you know what?
As a kid,
I was at New Salem Baptist Church.
Okay.
New Salem. And I talk about that in the book.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then I think I know you from Corinthian.
Corinthian, yes. Yeah. Oh, yes. Okay. Corinthian.
And you had a mm-hmm. couple shout-outs from, it was a couple of people from, I think, New Salem.
Okay.
But, you know, people remember you from down through the years when you leave such an impact on their life.
Yeah, I think so, because so many people have left a great impact for me.
Mm-hmm.
And when I think of Teddy Harris, and I learned so much from Teddy, not even on the saxophone, just business mm-hmm. and how he would handle his business,
mm-hmm.
and Ernie Rogers. And I just think of some of those guys that are Lamont, who plays saxophone. Mm-hmm. I remember one time he gave me a lesson, and I went away and came back 2 weeks later, and I was excited about this lesson, and I started playing it, and I said, "What you think, Lamont? What you think?" And Lamont Hamilton, and what he looked, he turned his head like,
"Really?"
You know when you're lying. Mm-hmm. And I didn't get it. I didn't get it until about 10 years later, because I didn't have it, because I started and I stopped and I started and I stopped. And I guess he wanted to tell me something that was profound, but that was profound for me because I didn't get it 2 years later. When you got it, you got it. You don't start and stop. Mm-hmm. You have it and you play it. So I learned a lot from the guys. And I think back then I put so much emphasis on playing and not myself playing, finding work for the guys in the band, plus myself, mm-hmm. opposed to really putting time in on my horn and thinking about me playing the saxophone. Mm-hmm. And I'm getting the opportunity to do that now, in spite of all the things that I do, mm-hmm. with the nonprofit, with the book, with the radio station, mm-hmm. All the different projects working between this gospel project now, as okay. well as this smooth jazz project, and then producing. I just produced a project on Dr. Mamie Smith, who's also the co-writer in my book.
All right.
Who, as well as the COO of Educational Arts.
All right.
And so she's a classical singer, classical pianist, and she teaches every Saturday at our place, at our school on the east side.
Okay. So and where is the school at?
It's on Glenfield. So if you're interested, just give me a call, mm-hmm. and I'll give you all the information and give you contact information for Dr. Smith.
Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. So now, if you had to give any of the young up-and-coming musicians a word, mm-hmm. what would you tell them?
Well, I would tell them to...
What would you tell your 10-year-old self?
Myself.
Your 10-year-old self.
They always say, practice, and I have a new word for that. It's perfect practice that makes perfect. You need to focus. You need
Good
to
word.
Focus mm-hmm. because you can do a whole lot of nothing.
Nothing. Mm-hmm.
And you can be the same place. Mm-hmm. You keep doing the same thing, you're going to keep having the same results. And I've done that. And praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Because he gives you a second chance.
Yes, he does.
You know, and I've been counted out a long time ago. Mm-hmm.
But look at you.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes. Praise the Lord. People would say that I'm not this, I'm not that. You can't do this, you can't do that. Mm-hmm. There was no way that I was supposed to be playing the saxophone with asthma. There was no way I was supposed to be getting around with rheumatic fever. There was no way that with ADHD, no way I can do any of this stuff mm-hmm. but God, you know. So don't tell me what you see. It ain't for you. What God has for you
That's
is
right.
for you.
That's
yes,
right.
it is.
So, you know, I'm good.
Okay.
I'm good.
So are you have any engagements coming up?
Yes, I do. One that I share, I'll be in Mount Clemens on the 6th at, it'll be on my webpage. It'll be on my Facebook
okay.
page. And on the 20th and 21st, I'll be at Baker's Keyboard.
Okay. And that's one of the oldest jazz clubs.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then I'll be at, a friend, she is giving me a book release.
Okay.
In fact, she was Bonnie's good friend.
Okay.
And Curly Mays, she's going to give me a, what do you call
book
it?
Book release party.
Yeah, book release party. Mm-hmm. And guess what? The
what?
Street is going to be on. Now, this is on Dexter and the street called Duane.
Okay.
Oh. Okay.
Right in the community.
Yeah, down by Davidson.
Right.
Yeah.
And she said, "What do you think?" I said, "It's wonderful." It's right in the community. Yes, I want to be right in the community.
Amen.
If I'm starting the book,
you're going to have to give us.
That's going to be
great. Yeah, you're going to have to give us the flyer, and we'll make sure that we post it, and we'll come back for the book.
Wonderful.
Please.
And I'd like to thank James LeLewis. Thank you for calling. Mm-hmm. I'd like to thank Reverend Dr. Joanne Watson.
Oh, yeah.
My first release was there. And it was really something special, really something special. So I haven't even begun yet. So we just, you know, a few little, you know, takeoffs. But the big one.
Oh, it's coming. I want to thank you for coming out today to be on this show and for blessing us. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to send this next song out to you, and it's going to be prophetic. And this is from Bishop Paul Morton. Your best days yet.
I accept.
Your best days yet. And thank you all for watching Brother Dwayne Parham. We'll be right back after this. This is WVTC, the gospel radio station right here in Detroit. Mm-hmm. We'll be back. Don't go nowhere.
You may think that it's over, that your life is done.
The best is yet to come.
Don't sweat the challenge. Your battle's already won.
Is yet to come.
Listen, y'all. See, God writes the end before the story began. He told me to tell you the best
is yet to come.
As the author of your faith, He wrote a provision for you to win. You're a winner, you're a winner, you're a winner.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
I don't care what people told you, you ain't seen them.
You ain't seen your best days.
Oh, well, is on the way. I see you eagle, I see you flying high. Ooh, you ain't seen nothing, you ain't seen nothing, you ain't seen nothing. I know you may think that you have, but God told me to tell you, you gotta keep on fighting, keep on praying. You ain't seen nothing yet. No, 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 no.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
You ain't seen your best days yet.
It's greater. It's greater. It's stronger.
You ain't seen your best days.
Oh, 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 oh.
That song, because you ain't seen nothing yet.
You ain't seen
eyes have not seen.
The best is yet to come.
Bishop said that before he walked out of the door. Yes. Eyes have not seen and ears have not heard.
Right,
but
right.
We say you ain't seen nothing yet.
That's why you have to live with. I may be sounding redundant, but it takes that for us to get it.
That's right. That's
that,
right.
You know, you have to expect your miracle.
Yep.
You have to expect your blessing.
Yeah. Yeah, you ain't seen nothing.
Because you ain't seen nothing yet.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
You ain't seen nothing
I'm so excited, I don't know what to do.
Me too.
I'm just, as my grandmother used to say, I'm excited. I'm excited.
And good anticipation.
Yeah, yeah.
Nervous and concerned and, no.
No, I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm excited.
Because old Paul got another song that said, whatever you're doing.
In this season.
In this season.
Don't do it without me.
Don't do it without me.
Don't do it without me. But I want to give a shout out to the twins and Irma Winston and Pastor Brock from Welcome. New Welcome Baptist Church, we want to say that. We'll give a shout out to Shell Rita from St. James. She was in the adult choir with us.
Oh, yeah, she was
in the adult choir. Teresa Acton, all the way from Kentucky. Utressa Johnson, good evening to you. First Lady Green is out here. We want to say hi to her.
All the way from Texas.
All right, all right. A singer from Singersville. Yeah, now that's a singer. That's a singer. Yeah, you want to know?
Hi, Alinda. And Sheree, my niece. Had that baby coming in. She's expecting her first baby.
Oh, how nice.
We're excited.
I'm
getting ready to be a great grand auntie.
A great grand auntie. Okay. So we'll take that. We'll take that. We'll take it all.
Right.
But we're just happy that so many stopped by. And wasn't that a lovely interview?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Such a humble man.
Yeah.
Yeah, such a humble man.
Full of talent.
Full of talent. Full of talent. And I know.
And what did he tell the kids? I practice.
Yep.
Practice.
Yep. And stay focused.
Stay focused.
Stay focused. If the Lord has you on
there. Two good nuggets for today.
Two good nuggets for today. And Roxy is out here watching,
hey,
too.
Hey,
and what we're trying to do is to get Blinky to call back in
so that
we can talk to her all the way from California, because she's going to solve the riddle of what were they saying on the Good Time song, and who would know either the writer or the singer. And
right.
She was the singer, so we want to make sure she's been online with us, but I want her to call in, and I want you guys to hear her voice. So we're thankful to God that we know a couple people, and we're thankful to Richard Darrell Nichols.
Of course.
Amen. Amen. We are thankful that he is out there with us.
Mm-hmm.
So you got a word while we wait?
We got a nugget while we wait.
All right, well, give us a nugget.
You know, we started with identity. We moved into growth. Talked about prayer. Talked about purpose. Now we're going to talk about strength. How we get our strength. And here it is. It's coming from 2 Corinthians 3:5. Not that we are sufficient of ourselves to think anything as of ourselves, but our sufficiency is of God. And then we support it with what? That favorite of everybody's, Philippians 4:13. I can do what?
All things
through Christ, which strengthens me. But when you got to understand where the strength comes from, where the idea
comes from. Mm-hmm. It's Him. The sufficiency is in Christ Jesus. That's so you right. got to know the man that gives out the strength.
That's right.
Then you can do it.
Then you can do it.
Then you can do it.
Yep, then you can do it.
How easy is that? And that's it on this nugget. Know that your sufficiency is in Christ Jesus. That's where it comes from. You do what you do because of Him. Because of Him. Who gets the glory?
He gets the glory.
He gets the honor. He gets the praise. Yep. And you'll get the blessing. You'll get the benefit.
See?
You'll get the check.
Praise the Lord. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's it on that one.
But he'll give you strength to do it.
He'll give you strength to do it.
Yeah, when everybody is going off,
yeah,
you can stay on.
And then you know what thought just came to me? And you have to be careful about being, distorting, being content in the state in which we're in. You know, it says we know how to abound mm-hmm. in the base.
Yeah, that's right.
But I think sometimes we throw that, we get that twisted. Because just because you find contentment, that does not mean you don't keep moving.
Right. I mean, you know.
All that means is that my attitude is always going to be positive.
My attitude
is going to be positive. And I'm going to be moving forward.
My attitude.
It's all about your state of mind.
My attitude.
Where's my attitude? Because you can get complacent. And Bishop said it. And you'd be. Okay.
But sometimes the Lord just has you in a holding pattern
mm-hmm.
because He's working everything else out
mm-hmm.
so
mm-hmm.
that everything can meet up at the same
mm-hmm.
time.
But your attitude. Your attitude is expectation. Expectancy.
Mm-hmm.
He's doing it. He's doing it for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I can do this because of Him.
Yeah.
Don't get it twisted.
Yeah.
I don't care what it is your talent and calling is. And don't care how much money you're making doing it. It is because of God.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't you.
That's right.
He gives the favor.
That's
he
right.
gives the promotion. It's God.
Yeah, promotion does not come from the east or the west.
And that's your strength. He is. Or as that little boy said on that song, he is my shrimp. Shrimp like no other.
He is my shrimp. Shrimp like no
shrimp
other.
Shrimp like no other. He is my strength. Strength like our strength is in Him.
Yep, it is. It is.
And Amen.
We're so happy that we have strength.
Strength.
In Him.
In Him.
In Him. In Him. Mm-hmm. Well, let's go to Beulah Grove Baptist Church.
Oh, sounds like
And Beulah Grove is Jesus. My rock.
See?
Strength.
Strength.
Okay, come
right.
on. We're going to do this. Stay right here on WVTC Detroit. We'll be right back, and hopefully we can get Blinky on this line.
Oh. Y'all clap your hands all over this room. Let's make it sound like you're church in here. We're going to take you out to the country. Come on. Good God. Here we go. Ezekiel said he saw him as a wheel in the middle of a wheel. John talked about him in the book of the seven seals. Some call him the Rose of Sharon. Others call him the Prince of Peace. But I call Jesus my God. Ezekiel said he saw him as a wheel.
bless you.
Well, I call Jesus
my rock.
He's the rock. Yeah, I call him several things because he's been a wheel in the middle of the world.
In my comfort.
He's been my shelter.
In a time
he's
of storm.
He's been my ride. He's been my driver.
He's been my clarity. He's been my peace.
Focus, honey.
My guide.
Yes. He's been my friend, honey, when I didn't have one. I thank him. He's been my healer.
My Lord. We can
go down the list.
Talk about
what you call Jesus.
My deliverer.
It's just a matter of what day it is.
What the situation is.
Right. As to what I'm going to call him.
He feels a many as you.
Yes, he does. And Miss Blinky, we trying to get you to call in, girl. Call in. Mm-hmm. I put the number there. Call in. Mm-hmm. Also, we had an incident here in Detroit-ish. it wasn't, thank God, it wasn't in Detroit, but it was in Michigan. So
close enough.
It was close enough. That we had a, yes, Blinky, I put the number there. Call the number. You got to call the number. 248-907-4243. Call that number. But we had last week a young man was working in Wendy's. In Michigan, hallelujah, and he decided, he was in Greenville, Michigan, and he decided, that's near Grand Rapids, that he was going to take a bath in the restaurant. Amen? Amen. He said, won't he make you clean inside?
And outside, too.
He said, won't he make you clean? He said, so I'm going to fix this outside up so the inside will look all right. So he took a bath in the Wendy's.
Wendy's.
I think we have the video over there. So let's watch this video.
Lord. Get in between all the cracks.
You know what? People like
wash yourself.
It feels like a hot tub. I'm just enjoying life. I could too. Hold on.
All right. See. And so they had to come and sanitize the restaurant. They fired everybody that was there because, did you see, somebody threw him a towel. And I guess he had soap because it was some bubbles. Yeah. And he said, feel like a hot tub.
Feel like a hot tub.
He done took a four-out bath.
So now you know when they ask the question, where'd they do that at?
It's no telling what all they don't do in these places.
That's right.
It makes me say, eat at home.
He just put it on film. TikTok.
Yes.
That's right. He put it on film, but you don't know what they're doing. So some of y'all need to get a cooking ministry and cook at home.
I have one. Get that cooking ministry and cook at home.
Well, we're going to try to make this work right here. We were talking yesterday about Janet DeBose.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And her homegoing, and we were talking about the songs. And the one song we started talking about was the song from The Good Times.
Good Times. The theme song from Good Times.
So we said, well, we know who sang the song.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And the person that sang the song is Sister Blinky Williams.
Mm-hmm.
Motown great Blinky Williams.
Right.
And we have her on the phone. How are you today, Sister Blinky?
I'm doing great, everybody. How are you doing? I'm sure enjoying this. How's everybody doing?
Oh, we're fine. Yeah, all is well.
A pleasure having you on the line.
Yes, it's a pleasure. A pleasure. But amen. Yeah, so, I mean, you recorded that song. You're the voice on the song, right?
Right, on Good Times, yeah. Me and a guy named Jim Kilstrap.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. So how did you get picked for the song?
I was with Sammy Davis at the time, okay. And we were in the studio working on a project with Motown, and okay. Motown just given Sammy a label called Mo West, and Dave Grusin was in the studio while we were recording. He said, I need to do the song right quick, and so I was introduced to Dave Grusin. I said, oh yeah, you're from Motown, Wicked, can you do it? And I said, but I need a guy, and it just so happened that Jim Gilstrap was there too to do some recording, and so that's how it got us. And a couple of members of the Celtics were there, Edna Wright, Gloria Jones. And so we just ended up doing the background and ended up doing the song.
Now, the Celtics were with Brother Andre Crouch, right?
And we were Andre's first group. We were like 16 and 17 years old.
Mm, wow.
And when we first recorded The Blood, that was Andre's first song, and we were his first group.
Okay.
So this was years later, and we were in the studio. We just decided that they would do it with me, which is a Good Times thing.
Okay. Wow!
Awesome.
So, were you? What? Now, did they record that in California? The Good Time thing? Or
yeah, we recorded in California, and when I was on Brother Nicholas, they had a contest in LA for the correct lyrics.
Oh.
And even online, there was an international contest. And so some of the lyrics were incorrect. And if you don't mind, I'd like to give you.
That's what we want.
Okay. The lyrics are just looking out of the window watching the asphalt grow, because the Evans family lived in the ghetto, so they didn't have no glass. Uh-huh. So all they could see outside their window was a parking lot. So it's just looking out the window watching the asphalt grow.
Okay.
Thinking of how it all looks hand-me-down, keeping your head above water, making a wave when you can, temporary layoffs, easy credit rip-offs, hanging in and jiving, scratching and surviving, and hanging in and jiving. Those are the lyrics.
Okay.
Well, there was an argument that the lyrics were hanging in a child.
Right.
No, they were poor, but they had to hang in no child line. It was hanging in and jiving. You know, because black folks, we knew how to have a good time inside the house.
That's right. Oh, wow. So, now, you said they had a contest, the radio had a contest out in California?
Yes, in California. And then they also had one in Las Vegas. And so my daughter called me. She said, Mom, there's a contest right now in Las Vegas and on singing the correct lyrics. And Mommy, I know the correct lyrics. Would it be unfair for me to enter the contest? and so I said no. So she entered, and there was an argument, so she gave me the number, and I called in, as Blinky, as the singer of the song, and I said, so whoever the girl is that just called in and just sang the song, she sang it correctly, so she won the contest. She won $300.
Okay, all right. So what have you been doing?
Well, right now I'm in Las Vegas at an international convention. I'm one of the music directors for the Asians and Japanese and Korean spiritual seminar. And
okay.
I guess it's about 18,000 people here.
Wow.
Between the ages of 18 and maybe 45 and 50. So I just closed down at the Catalina Jazz Club in Hollywood, and then I came here.
Okay.
To work with them. And I praise God, because, you know, the Lord will open up doors for you.
Won't he, Will?
Okay, and sometimes it's the stage, sometimes it's the pulpit, and sometimes it's the nightclub.
It's the Lord, that's right.
If you look on my Facebook page, I called my brother at the end of my show to come and pray for the people who were all there at the club to see me, because most of them were Christians anyway.
So how long is that convention going on?
That's exciting.
This convention will end on tomorrow. They've been here 7 days. Okay. It's almost like GMWA. It's just that they speak probably about 20% English. But let me tell you, they know how to sing these songs.
Okay. Woo. Okay. Okay. No joke.
Yeah. Okay.
My goodness.
Yeah, how would you like to hear How Great Is Thy God sung in Korean? Ooh. Or hear Amazing Grace sung in Japanese? Ooh. Or Chinese? It would just wear you out.
Wow. Yeah. Wow.
That's right. That's wow.
That's wonderful.
That deserves a wow.
Yeah. So we want to bless your ministry.
Amen.
And wherever you sing, that you are a blessing to those people.
Praise
that hear
God.
Yes, wherever you say.
Wherever you
are. We don't have nothing. It could be a church, it could be a nightclub,
right.
It can be on the corner of the block. Because you have blessed us for many years.
Yes, you
right on good times, lady. Yes, and that voice comes right on through.
Yes,
on
it
good
does.
Times. And even in syndication, we're all sitting around
right.
the TV, and now we can sing the right words.
Yes. Now we can sing the right words.
Now you just sing the right words.
That's right.
I am so glad for Brother Nichols who I'm happy to call in.
Yeah.
And I was just listening to, I was blessed these 2 little minutes. I couldn't hear because I forgot I had turned off my phone during the earlier session, and I didn't understand why it wasn't working. I had to go in the settings to turn the phone back on.
Well, I am so, so, so glad that you called.
Yes.
But you know what?
So I'd like to, can I listen to it again? When are you on again?
Oh, we're on every Monday and Tuesday right here. On we're live on Mondays and Tuesdays. And what we can do is we want you to call back in because I'm sure you have a word for the people.
Amen.
You have
Amen.
Well, you know what? I'm going to put this on my Facebook page and announce it in this evening session so that some of my friends from other countries can listen to you.
All right. All
Look
right.
At
and there you have
it.
Yes. And you can turn around and you'll be able to play it right back.
Right.
Yep.
Right.
Yep.
Okay. Okay, this is wonderful. Well, I really appreciate you accepting me and letting me share. And I'm going to sneak back in here because I put my finger up in the air when I walk out.
Right, right, yeah.
They don't know what that finger means.
Excuse me.
Yeah, you had to put that Baptist,
finger.
Well, we love you, Blinky. We love you. And there's absolutely nothing you can do about it. We love you.
Yes, we do.
We do.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. God bless you. And I'm going to spread the word.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
We love
God bless you, darling. Bye-bye.
God bless you. Bye-bye. All right, that was none other than Blinky Williams, all the way from she's in Las Vegas.
She's in Las Vegas.
And the Lord will open doors.
He'll open
Won't he
doors.
Do it?
We're gonna do a little throwback right here. This is a way back song.
Okay, go way back.
We're going way back. This Tremaine, we're gonna stay on the West Coast.
All right,
all right.
This is the one y'all will remember. This one. Now this one they did play in the club.
Okay.
Fall Down on Me.
Right here on WBTC.
All right.
Fall down on
now,
me.
Now, that was a blast from the past.
Yes.
That was a blast. We had so many. Regina said, that was my jam. She said, I did. Michael Peter said, I remember that old school. I was in the 70s. Yeah. Yeah. In his 20s. Plus, he had that record. Yep. And Gina could talk about they played that one at UBQ all the time.
She remembered the name of the club. Okay.
Not the UBQ.
UBQ.
Okay, right there. Oh, I think it was like down on Harper. She, yeah. Po Jackie, God bless her heart. Because she been saved and sanctified the whole time. Ooh, I felt that right there. But we're so excited that we were able to have Blinky.
Yes, that was awesome. That was awesome.
Isn't that something?
That was awesome.
It is.
Wow.
Look at God.
And she's such a kind person. I met her through Anna Tatum.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Years ago.
God for Edna.
Yeah. Thank God for Edna.
Listen, and everybody the Lord lets you run into.
It's for a reason.
There's purpose behind it.
Yeah. Nothing just happens.
Right.
And the Lord knew this day was coming. And we was going to talk about that song. And he said, I'm going to make this happen. Yep. And so now we know what the word.
Isn't that amazing?
Yeah. And I mean, what other station can you tune in and get the
actual singer
from Good Times to call in? So,
come on now. Look at God.
God worked that thing.
Yeah, he did.
Did he work it?
And we ain't even asked him.
Ain't prayed a prayer.
Lord, can you?
He just said, I'm going to throw this in. Mm-hmm. I'm going to throw this in. This a bonus.
This a little bonus.
Yeah, just a little
Amen.
Bonus.
We were blessed
All
by
right.
Her.
But we thank God we see Tim Turner Jr., one of my favorite drummers, percussionists, Lena Brown. And we want to make sure that we say that there will be GMWA Detroit rehearsal this week, 7 Amen. O'clock at Craig Memorial, 14201 Puritan at Ardmore. So you want to be there. We also want to say good afternoon, good evening to Carl Nunnally, mm-hmm. Our singer from Singersville, another one. I sang with him in St. James. Okay. Ronald Leggett can sound just like Luther.
Ronald Leggett?
Yes.
Can sound just like?
Baby, Ronald Leggett ain't no joke.
Okay.
And Dee Dee is watching, so we are. Okay, well, we want to say hello and thank you all. We don't take you turning this station on lightly because you can be doing many other things. Mm-hmm. But where else could you go and hear Blakey?
Mm-hmm. I mean, for real.
The actual
singer. Mm-hmm. Yep.
She was at a conference with how many people, she said?
18,000.
Foreigners.
Yeah, because she's an Asian.
We kept saying, why won't she call back? That's why.
That's why. She had to leave out of the. That's what she told
she
us.
She put the finger up.
Yeah, and had to leave out of the conference to go out into the hallway. That's what you do. You don't talk on your phone in church.
Don't talk in church. Although I've seen them do it.
Oh, Lord, me too.
I've seen them
do it. I've seen them do it.
Hello,
what? I've seen them do it.
Yeah.
It's like, that's not really happening.
I've seen them do it.
They gonna steal that song, girl, don't you?
That's Kirk Carr's song, girl.
Don't you do
I've
it.
I've seen them do
Honey,
it.
Kirk gonna come and you said they gonna redo that song.
We own no rights to the song.
No.
Kirk Carr had already done his own song. No, ain't no sense Kirk you trying to say, steal Kirk that. That's say, Kirk Carr's think, song.
He gonna say, oh, Lord. Somebody gonna say, I'm gonna redo that song. That's Juliet's version.
That is not Juliet's version. That is Kirk Carr's version.
That is Juliet's version. All right. Mm-hmm. But we are so thankful that everybody tuned in today. It's just
Amen.
Been a blessing.
From all across the country.
It has.
We have so many. From all
we also have.
have, did you, were you able to get his information up? But since we couldn't put it on the screen, we'll also put it on our Facebook page. But if you want to get in touch with Dwayne Parham, it's E-A-M-Z-T. E-A-M. E as in Edward, A as in Apple, M as in Mary, Z as in Zebra, T as in Todd, radio.com. Mm-hmm. Or EASZmusic.org. Mm-hmm. And you can also you can email him at theparham2@yahoo.com. What do we have here?
It's right. No Z in there. It's E-A-M-T. All right.
And he said on this card, we have DwayneParham.net. You can get him there. Or you can get him at E as in Edward, A as in Apple, M as in Mary, T as in Tom, radio.com. E-A-M-T, radio.com.
All right, so there's many ways.
Many ways. Many ways.
All right.
Many ways that you can get in touch with Dwayne Parham.
Just be
and you want to make sure that you get that book. And I'm really anxious to listen to this. So it's just been great. It's mm-hmm. been great. Mm-hmm. So God is good.
Yes, he is. All
yes,
the
he
time.
Is. And this weekend is Pastor David Johnson's weekend, right?
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
This Friday night, mm-hmm. 7 o'clock mm-hmm. on Clinger.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, mm-hmm. we're going to be there. This Saturday night for the Leap concert for mm-hmm. Kingdom Covenant Church. Mm-hmm. He's been there 25 years in ministry.
Already.
In ministry. And this Friday night, this is Gene night. Okay. And you can, the special guests are Kevin Stewart, Larry Callahan, and S.O.G.
Redeem. Mm hmm.
Great Emmanuel Voices of Detroit of Deliverance.
Great Emmanuel, that's our choir.
Oh, okay. Declaration yep. Praise and who?
And the dancers of King okay. of Kingdom Covenant Church. And Dina Nicole Bass.
Yes.
So you want to be there. It's gonna be on Clinger Street. Put that back up for 1 second so we can get that address. 17357 Clinger Street mm-hmm. in Detroit, and he wants you to come and rep mm-hmm. your whoever your favorite rep. Nike, Adidas, mm-hmm. whoever you want to wear. If you want to wear you, okay, mm-hmm. wear you. But make sure that you are in the place, mm-hmm. and it's What's going to be a wonderful, 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 wonderful time. Mm-hmm. So we'll be there. Mm-hmm. And again, workshop rehearsal is this weekend, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and we're looking forward to that.
And this weekend is my church's 39th church anniversary.
Oh, wow.
On Sunday.
And what's your church?
Greenfield Avenue Church of God.
And where
period.
Is that? Period. Yeah. Because I met somebody and I said, oh, you got to know. They said, no, it's the Church of God. And he went on.
The Church of God. Period. Greenfield and Pembroke. We got a special guest singing.
Nice church.
Guest pastor, Emeritus Leo Robinson, guest speaker for that one. This is the 39th, so we're not doing it as big as next year. Mm-hmm. Next year, we're going to have it going on. We want everybody there. For the 40th, but this is 39th, and so, but we are cooking. We're having dinner.
Oh,
we're having dinner, and
yeah, you better come on
this Sunday.
This Sunday, so we have a guest speaker this Sunday morning, and then we're having dinner afterwards.
Is Mr. Cooking? Mr. Playing?
You know, Mr.'s still in a thing in a booth.
Oh, he can't play.
He hasn't been to church, but hopefully this Sunday he will be at church.
Oh, Mr.
He hasn't been to church in a month, so he'll be.
Mr.
M-I-S-T.
Come on, mister.
We're gonna try to get him at church Sunday.
That's right.
For anniversary. So we're excited at the 39 years.
Yeah, and Regina said they have good dinners. Because we can
and
testify.
It's free.
Yeah, we can
it's
test
free.
Yeah, but you need to come to church first. So don't just show up.
at dinner time and yeah. Thank you gonna eat. Yeah, come to church first.
Eat and it's free.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, come to church first. David Brock is on with us today.
Pastor Brock, we love you.
Yes, we do. And our women will be singing soon, and we'll give you some more information about them because we're going on tour.
All right now.
Oh, the women are going on tour.
And okay. It's all right now.
They're going to steal that song from you, girl.
Think I'll make it anyhow.
They're going to steal that song from you. But yeah. We are so glad that the Lord has allowed us to do this. We've had a great show with Dwayne Parham. And with our special guest.
Telephone guest.
Blinky. Ain't we lucky we got him, Williams.
Amen.
And is watching the asphalt grow.
Because they didn't have grass.
Now,
that helped me understand. You did help me understand that yesterday. Mm-hmm. But I'm appreciative of that now. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She brought a little context to it. Mm-hmm. So we're glad about that. Closing thoughts, Juliet?
Yes, but asphalt did glow. I just want to make that point clear.
It does glow
when the sun is hitting it and makes it hot.
That's true.
I understand.
Just put that egg out there.
Yes, honey. I had to put it out there because I don't want to make it seem like I'm crazy, because I'm not.
All right. Amen.
It's just not the lyrics.
Yes, that's okay. Not the lyrics, though.
Oh, Lord.
It's the actual.
Yes.
I got you. You know.
That's factual.
That's the natural side.
That's factual.
That's the natural side. Yeah. And you see it, and it's, you know, if it get too hot, that asphalt
starts
start
waving.
Yeah, waving.
That's right. It sure will.
And you'll think it's a mirage. The love I saw in you was just a mirage. I thought it was love.
Is that Motown lyrics?
It was not love.
What is that you spewing?
Yes, that was Smokey. And Micah Jackson said,
but Smokey is quite a poet. And he's a writer.
Yeah, he is.
Because he was on Facebook or whatever that was. I saw
Yeah, that's an older clip. But
he was really, really chit-chatting up some stuff. I was on there mesmerizing him, like, look at this Negro go.
Well, you know, he did a lot of the writing.
Well, I know that. I already know that about him. But I'm talking about this particular clip.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
And he was our speaker for FAN, and we want to give Regina a shout out. Great job, Regina. Great job, Duchess of Sussex.
Yes,
you are
an
asset to the United States.
You're the ambassador. You're the ambassador. Thank you.
We're glad to have you in the United States.
Yes.
Amen.
Our own Duchess.
That's right. Our own Duchess. Let's make sure we make it to Pastor David Johnson's church on Friday night. Also, there'll be workshop rehearsal. Make it to your church on Sunday morning and get that food.
And dinner.
You get fed spiritually, and then they feed the natural
dining sufficient.
Amen. Amen. Said he went fishing.
What?
I mean, you catch.
but we are so glad. We're going to make way for Ron Todd. And the Ron Todd Show.
Amen.
Right here on this station. So we don't want you to go anywhere. Uh-uh. Remember, don't click on no strange links on the email.
Save yourselves.
If they call you, just hang up the phone. Just hang up the phone. If they say this is the IRA and you just say click. Hang it up. Don't be nosy. Just hang up. And then go back and block that call so that you don't get that call again. And
blocking don't help.
Oh,
these
helped
babies
me.
Done got clever. You block it and they'll change the number slightly.
Okay. And I'll block that one too.
That one.
I know I got 100
They are
calls
very persistent. at trying to fool you.
They're trying to separate you from your money.
Did you?
Yes, I did. I bought the blocker.
You
can buy a blocker.
Really?
You can buy a blocker you can be the blocker. Now, you can block it yourself.
Richard, app store got a blocker?
Stop it.
We ain't advertising nobody.
Oh.
But we're looking, thank God for Richard Darrell Nichols. He says, thank you, Richard, for getting in touch with Blinky for us.
Yes.
And he says, Smokey Robinson turned 80 on Saturday.
What?
Yeah, he should be by that. Yeah, that should be right. Because I know how old I am.
Because my mama's 77, so Smokey got to be 80.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, but the love I saw in you.
Don't keep saying them lyrics.
I thought.
Stop it.
It was more than that.
And quit looking like that about it.
It was just a mirage.
Okay.
Wow.
Something is happening.
Something is
happening when we get to the last 15 minutes of the show. Y'all pray our strength.
Our
strength won't fail.
Yes, we are thankful for Diane, amen, who is always faithful to us. And amen. We love Chuck, and there ain't nothing you can do about Chuck.
Can you put the flyer up, Chuck?
That's my Chuck. That's my Chuck. Thank you, Juliet.
Yeah.
Thank you, Pastor Jackie. We love you.
And thank you, Sandy Rose.
All right.
Thank you, Sandy.
It's all good. Thank you, Blinky. Thank you, Dwayne. Thank you, everybody. Lottie Dottie.
Can you put the flyer up, Chuck?
Night.
Elder Rudolph Stanfield.
VTC Radio Detroit.
Thank you for listening to The Sandy Rose Show with your host, Sandy Rose. If you have enjoyed this broadcast, won't you consider liking and sharing this with a friend or family member? We'd love for you to share it on your Facebook page. Thank you for tuning to WVTC Radio Detroit. Remember to like and share this broadcast with a friend. We are WVTC, winning victory through Christ. The views and opinions expressed on the previous broadcast are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the official policy or position of WVTC Radio Detroit, its advertisers, or affiliates.
WVTC Radio Detroit. You can find us on Facebook, YouTube, our website, www.wvtcradio.com, or download our WVTC app from the Play Store for Android users and the App Store for iPhone users.